let's get specific there. Let's say someone comes and they want to become a citizen, mm-hmm. and they're Catholic, and they say, do you believe in same-sex marriage? And they say, no, I don't. Do they get in, or is that a, do they now have an anti-Canadian value?
Well, look, Evan, I think that this is a discussion that Canadians want to have. And for myself, as I mentioned to you, there are certain values. But the great thing about this country and what makes our country so, so sought after for people to come to is that we can have a difference in priorities. We can have a discussion about that. But what's even more valuable is that we have that based in a framework of equality, that we can have differences of opinion. We, in fact, don't impose our differences of opinion on each other, and we have the tolerance to resolve those differences peacefully.
But,
so this
isn't
about choosing how you
align. You're saying all that,
it's about protecting.
You're saying all that, but when I'm trying to get you on something specific, that's all true. Mm-hmm. But you know, I'm just wondering if this is a solution without a problem. For example, would a Catholic person who doesn't believe in same-sex marriage, which is law here, would they fail this test? Would an Orthodox Jewish person who believes that a woman needs her head covered by a wig, would they fail this test? That's the reality of what this values test would be. On those particular cases, would they pass the test?
Now look, Evan, I'm not going to go point by point, issue by issue, and trivialize this issue. I think we as Canadians share a certain set of values, and I'm looking forward to having a discussion with Canadians about that.
When I'm trying to get a specific answer, as you say, I'm trivializing it, but you know, the border is about specific cases. And you know, Ronna Ambrose was on this program saying she disagreed with you, but Michael Chong, another candidate, called this dog whistle politics. Here's the definition of dog whistle politics: a type of political speech using code words that appear to mean one thing to the general population but have a different meaning to a targeted part of the audience. The fundamental issue is he believes you're saying anti-Canadian values, but you're sliding away from the specifics because you're insinuating that it's targeting one group. What do you say to that? Which, you know, people have compared to Donald Trump, how he does it. What do you say to that?
Well, I think they're fundamentally false. For myself, I don't think it's intolerant to have a discussion about Canadian values that we hold dear.